Everybody, and welcome to another off-topic video. Today we're going to be talking about demonetization and what that means for me. What it means for me as a YouTube channel and going forward. So at this point, everyone would be like really freaking out about, oh my gosh, my ads got taken away, I'm not making AdSense money anymore, oh my gosh, my life is over, my YouTube career just went down the drain, yada yada, because of the whole new restrictions around you need 1,000 subscribers and you need 4,000 hours of watch time. So I'm not in the basket of this is a concern for me, because this is actually a really good thing for me. I no longer have to worry about finding music that I have to get specifically royalty free to download and then put it in like speed paint or something that I was doing. Like, I no longer have to worry about my Dead by Daylight videos being instantly demonetized because they're already demonetized. It's just a video now. Like, I'm not making money off it. There are so many things about this whole setup that happen that actually helps me a lot. Now I have more time to focus on games that I don't care will be demonetized, because now I can focus solely on the fact of making the videos that I want, using the music that I want, and all sorts of stuff like that. Like, I don't have to worry about any of this garbage anymore. Like, I know, I get it, a lot of people see this as an issue, but as I've said multiple times, I don't care about the money aspect of things. So the fact that I no longer have to worry about demonetization is amazing. I mean, I've made cash outs on YouTube. It was awesome. Like getting paid for something that you like doing, making games and blah, blah, blah. But at the same time, like I said in my last video when I talked about having a stalker and the fact that I didn't care about making money, it's that the reason that YouTube will never be something that I'll be so invested in is because it's so hard to upload the videos. Like, I tried to upload a video the other day of a Dragon Age Inquisition playthrough with the dwarf that I was doing, Who's Gonna Romance Dorian. And when I tried to upload the video, it got all the way done, but as soon as it hit the processing stage, like it was about 45% done on processing, it died. And now I have to do it all over again. This is why doing YouTube is not going to be a big deal for me, and it never will, unless, I don't know, miraculously I can have an internet plan that gives me a better upload speed or something, I don't know. But basically the gist of it is, I'm not going to stop. If any of you who followed me and subscribed to me are worried that I'm going to stop uploading videos now, does it look like I'm stopping? I just uploaded Friday the 13th a video. Well, yeah, it was a silent playthrough because it was when I had finished recording, I suddenly finally got Jason, and I was like, oh, I'm going to record this, but my microphone's not going to be on because there's all this sound going on. Yeah, I'm still uploading, guys. I'm never going to stop. In fact, a Dragon Age Inquisition playthrough will be coming up shortly. Like, if any of you watch this video, let me know if you want to see a dwarf romancing Dorian first, or a Dalish mage romancing Cullen, because my Cullen romance video that I made isn't exactly complete. It's missing a few of his dialogue bits before you get to Skyhold. I will be uploading both of them in the end anyway, but just let me know which one you want me to upload first. Getting back onto the topic really quick about my stalker though, the drama that happened a whole month ago, because I'm pretty sure it has been a month now, it hasn't stopped. In fact, he's continued to make a video about me at the same time that I did, so like kind of after I made my video, he made his, and then very recently he made another video about me, which was calling me a complainer just to complain. I don't think mentioning to my subscribers what I'm going through in regards to his creepy antics is really me complaining. It's more like an update of, I don't know, kind of like my personal life. I've never really done that a lot on YouTube, but I did for the sake of it, because, I don't know, some people just really need to know what's going on with, like, certain people that they like watching. Like, say someone really liked watching Alex's videos. I think they'd be more interested in knowing who he was as a person. It might not stop them from watching his videos, but I think it would be nice to know who he is as a person to get, like, more of a personal feel of the YouTuber. Like, one thing that I want to talk about, which is why I'm talking about it now, is because in his latest video, he talked about how he tried to help my channel get more monetization. Now, the messages proving what I'm saying is true have been lost on a site called Tally for God Ministries. We used to talk on this in the chat system, but I tried going back and finding his profile and clicking chat with him to try and reload my old conversations with him. Unfortunately, the conversations are lost forever unless any of you can tell me how to try and find messages that have been sent on the internet in the event that that doesn't happen, you're just going to have to take what I say as hearsay, or, you know, believe me, don't believe me, hearsay, whatever. I don't really care. Okay, so he's saying how he tried to help me get more monetization on YouTube. He tried to tell me that what I should do is play arcade games. Like, I should actually go to an arcade and play arcade games. He was trying to say how, oh, you know, you don't need all these other games to get big on YouTube and blah, 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 and stuff like that. Well, the fact that he's totally missing the fact that I play these games because I like these games. It's like, I get enjoyment out of playing with my friends. So, he's constantly telling me how I should go out to arcades, play these games. Yeah, it costs a little bit of money and stuff like that to play the games, but it's totally worth it and stuff like that. So, I tried to explain to him, now this is in another video I made, which I believe is called I Walked Away From God Living With A Disability, or something like that. I explain in depth, and he has seen the video, I know he has, because he saved all my videos off of my alternate channel, which explains that I have a physical disability and I can't stand up for long periods of time. Like, as soon as I stand up for about 2 minutes, 3 minutes, I start getting a lot of pain because I have back issues, and it's an actual disability thing. So, that video that I talked about then, that he has seen, went in a lot more depth about what I was actually dealing with. But for those of you in layman terms, my spine is shaped like an S and there's a gap in it. That's the way I can say it without getting all medical terms that you guys won't understand. So, I tried to explain to him that this is never going to be a thing I'll be able to do because I don't have money, I don't have a job. Like, I don't have a job, I don't drive, I don't have L's, P's, an open license, so I can't drive. And I don't have money to go to these places and all sorts of stuff. I don't have a car, I can't go there, and all sorts of stuff like that. So I try to explain to him that, and you have to stand up to play arcade games, sometimes you get to sit and whatever. So I try to explain to him that this is never going to be something that I can do. But he just never listened to me. He always said, like, yeah, well, it is a good idea, you know, you should do it, you know, it'll help you out and stuff. He never once wanted to listen to the fact that I couldn't do it. He just wanted to push his idea onto me, because that's what he does. He just pushes his idea onto you, and if you don't like it, well then tough, because what his way says is the right way, and all other ideas are just totally wrong. So it's basically Alex's way or the highway, which I think is, like, really dumb. Like, that's another thing I never liked about him. It's always his way or it's no way at all. So, if you see any of his videos constantly saying how he tried to help me get more monetization, that's the story behind that. That's what he tried to get me to do. And when I explained I couldn't do it, he's just like, yeah, well, maybe you should just do it anyway, you know, like, it's worth it in the end, yeah, it costs a bit of money. Like, he just basically obliviously skipped over everything I said, like, he didn't care at all. This conversation happened in Telly for God Ministries in the chat system, but the other video made, which actually detailed my disability, was on an alternate channel that he has seen. So he definitely knew about my disability, he just chose to ignore it. And now this is when the lies come out, and he's, like, constantly saying how he tried to help me, but I stabbed him in the back. Well, realistically, he didn't help me at all. So, that's a touch-up on that drama. And that's basically all there is for this video. So, thank you all for watching my off-topic conversation about my stalker and my demonetization, which is actually a good thing in regards to the demonetization. And I hope to see you all in the next video, which may or not be more Dead by Daylight or maybe some Star Wars or something like that. So I'll see you in the next one, guys. Bye!